All right, so the new technologies that can help with climate change, there are two that come to mind. So the first one is water use efficiency. And so you would want to look at how we manage water very well, not wasting water, and looking at how you can use as irrigation facilities, efficient irrigation facilities, and then how you would do intensification as well. So with intensification, you are looking at the size of land you have and how you are going to apply, inputs in such a way that you would use the water very efficiently. That's number one. The other one is got to do with food seeds, which kinds of seeds that would be very tolerant to drought, and that would also be tolerant to insects and pathogens, because we all know that climate change in this week has brought about a lot of incidents of disease and pests. And so when we develop new varieties of seeds that are able to withstand these climate variations with respect to water use and drought, with respect to resistance to pests and diseases, this will be very commendable.
You know, India is self-sufficient in rice, wheat, and other crops, but in pulses, oil seeds, we are deficient. So we have to improve, diversification of crops. For example, Punjab, they are growing rice, wheat. They should also diversify to pulses, oil seeds, fruits, vegetables, and those kind of things. So, but on the other hand, agriculture also should move from production to, nutrition, climate change issues, and those things are very important, because, almost 50 to 60% cannot afford a healthy diet. Healthy diet is having fruits, vegetables, fish, chicken, and other things. So they can't afford. So they are eating mostly cereals and other things. So we have to diversify to millets, pulses, oil seeds, and the animal source foods like chicken and those things.
I really have to thank the Indian government for helping the conference to take place in this complex. I think for India, I have observed the changes in this country for the last 3 decades, maybe even 4 decades, and lots of changes have happened. So number one is the productivity of food and agriculture production has increased so fast. So that's why the number of hungry people, the number of malnourished people have come down very quickly, very dramatically. Farmers' incomes have improved. The consumers have access to better, healthy, nutritious foods. But the country continue to face some challenges. So for example, the degradation of natural resources, then the increased overweight obesity, and still some hungry people, and the people who lack of micronutrients like iron, zinc, vitamin A, and so on. In the meantime, the climate change is hitting this country very severely. So that's why we must continue to work together to make sure the successes we achieved during the Green Revolution, or even for the last 2 decades, will continue. And the overall agriculture growth, overall improvement in nutrition health of population will help the whole country to grow, to develop. So, and as a person from China, we're very much looking forward to working with our Indian colleagues